Welcome to Fabric Monday. Today we'll talk about data flow staging in Microsoft Fabric. Data flow Gen 2 staging. What is this? It uses a lake house and a data warehouse as a staging. Maybe when you create a data flow, you may already have noticed that a new lake house and a new data warehouse are created together. The data flow. They will be used by the staging process of the data flow Gen 2. The lake house is really called staging, but the data warehouse is used for a different process, which we call compute. We have in fact two phases, stage and compute. The lake house does the staging and the data warehouse does the compute. Here you see the data flow staging lakehouse and the data flow staging warehouse, which in fact is used for the compute test. This may be one of the last images that you have seen about these objects. Why? Because Microsoft promised that they will hide these objects, will not see these objects in Power BI Portal anymore. And this is becoming true. This object is starting to not appear in the portal anymore. Only under special conditions, this object still appear in the portal. You are about to not see this object anymore. On one hand, this is good, because we will not have this object disturbing our work. On the other hand, it will be more difficult to understand these internal concepts of the data flow than to the staging and the compute concept. When the staging is not needed, are there situations when we don't need staging? Yes, there are situations when we don't need the staging. If the processing in memory is enough for the amount of data, if we don't have too much data, and make the processing memory is enough, in this case we don't need to enable staging. We can just rely on the in-memory process. And if query folding is used for most or all the transformations, in this case the transformations are being processed in the source. And the data flow doesn't have to make any transformations, any processing, so the staging may not be needed. And that's the point. If you choose correctly when enable staging and when not enable staging, you'll be optimizing your data flows. If you enable staging when you don't need, the data flow will be slower. If you don't enable staging when you need, the data flow will be slower. So, you need to choose carefully. Let's talk about disabling staging. Why disabling staging? Because staging is enabled by default. When you create a data flow, it's enabled by default. It will use staging. It will use the lake house for the staging. Let's see how we disable this process. I'm on the Fabric Portal with a data flow Gen 2 open. The data flow Gen 2 is called Aggregation 1 and the query is called Fact Sale. How do I know this query is with staging enabled? The first thing is the format of the name. If the staging is disabled, the name is in italic, is written in italic. So this staging is enabled. Another option, better, is to right click the query and check the enable staging option. So enable staging is enabled. So staging is enabled for this query. And I can disable staging. See what I said about the letter, the name is in italic, illustrating for us that the staging for this query is disabled. Let's take a look on a comparison of the execution of this GUI with staging enabled and disabled. This is the aggregation 1. So I'll check the refresh history for aggregation 1. The first execution, the oldest execution, had staging enabled. And the execution immediately after that had the staging disabled. The difference is only 1 second. In this case, it was not very worth it to disable staging. Yes, true. Why? Because the table I'm using, the FastSave table, has 50 million records. Disabling staging and putting 50 million records to be processed in memory, although the transformations are using query folding, it was not worth it. Let's get back to our data factory and confirm that the transformations are using query folding. How do I know if the transformations are folding? I right click the last one and I check if the view data source query is enabled. If the view data source query is enabled, it means that all the transformations are being converted in a single SQL statement. So query folding is being used. That's good. This allows me to disable staging, but with an amount of 50 million records, the difference was not meaningful. The result was absolutely the same. So you need to make tests to identify when to enable or when to disable the stage. Back to our PowerPoints. Let's talk now about staging and compute. Staging is required if the target is a data house. You can't disable staging if the target of the query is a data house. You need to have staging. This may be bad because this means that when the target is a data house, the data flow chain tool will always be using staging even when not needed. Even when the processing could be done in memory, but because the target, the staging is required. Staging is recommended with big amount of data. Compute is the second level of staging. What this means? This means that if we get a query which is already with staging enabled and make another calculation and generate another query over that, so we'll be using compute. Yes, you know these are dynamic queries in Power Query. Dynamic queries make use of compute. This means that they will be processed using the data warehouse, the staging data warehouse created for the data flow. Compute is required when transforming a query already using staging. So when you create a query over another query already using staging, compute is required. Compute can be downgraded to staging. How we do that? Let's talk about managing staging and compute. I'm back to my Fabric portal. Now I'm on another data flow, a second data flow called aggregation 2. I have 2 queries on this data flow. The first query is making aggregation over the FastSave table, which has 50 million records. The second query is making an aggregation over the first query. In this case, you see this lightning symbol on the query. This means this is the dynamic query, and because this is a dynamic query, it will be using the compute stage of data flow gen 2. The compute will be used. I said it could be downgraded. How do we downgrade this from the compute to staging? or even to do everything in memory. Simple. If I get the first query and disable staging for the first query, in this case the second query is only using staging. And I can even disable staging on the second query as well, and both queries will be processed in memory. In this case, I have staging completely disabled for both, not using compute, not using staging. So we can choose, we can downgrade the queries or let them use staging and compute. It's a choice and we need to choose correctly, otherwise we'll have performance problems on our data flow. And it's interesting to note that I can enable staging for the first query. The first query is using staging on this example now, but the second query is not using compute because I disabled the staging. Having disabled staging means that the second query will be processed in memory. So use compute is not required. If I disable staging, it will be processed in memory. Let's analyze the difference on the execution times of the queries with staging compute enabled and with everything disabled. I'm on my workspace, aggregation 2. Let's take a look on refresh history. The first execution, which had staging and compute enabled, took 2 minutes and 30 seconds. When I disable staging and compute, the second execution took 1 minute and 4 seconds. So you see the difference is about 1 minute and 30 seconds of difference, more or less. In this case, disabling staging made a good improvement on the execution time. Back to our PowerPoint. Let's take a look on a summary of all this. We have our data sources. We can make processing in memory, totally in memory, and generate an output. This can be done except if the output goes to a data warehouse. If the output goes to a data warehouse, the staging is absolutely required. Or if the amount of data is too much, we can choose to use staging. And from the staging, the data can go to the output destination. But if we make additional transformations over the tables already in staging, then instead of from the staging, the table go back to the destination, the table will go to the compute stage, and from the compute will go to the destination. So we have 2 phases, staging and compute, which can be enabled or not for data flow gen 2. Thank you very much for watching. See you next week.